students, today we are starting chapter number 15, data handling. First I will give you introduction about this chapter and then we will do first exercise. So first thing is, what is data? In our daily life we collect various numerical facts and various informations. Suppose if we talk about a school, then in a school we will collect information about different classes. In each class how many students are there, then students' name, age, their height, weight, marks, like this many type of facts we are collecting. From these type of facts, only the numerical facts which are in number form, that we will call data. So data is the collection of numerical facts. Next thing is raw data. Raw data means originally collected data. Suppose if I talk about in a class 10 students test marks are 3, 0, 5, 4, 7, 2, 1, 9, 5 and 2. Okay, these are the marks of 10 students. These originally collected data it is. So we will call it roll number wise it is, and then this we will call raw data. Next thing is arranged data. Arranged data means if we arrange the data in ascending or descending form. Suppose this data if I will arrange in ascending order, so small to big. So first 0 is there, then 1, then 2 times it is, then 3, 4, 5, 7 and 9. So this we will call arranged data in ascending or descending order. Next thing is observation. Observation means each numerical figure. So here we have, you can see this is one observation, this is an observation, this is also an observation. All these are observation. So how many observation we have here? 10 observations are there. Next thing is the frequency. So frequency means the number of times a particular observation occur. So if we talk about 0, how many times 0 is coming here? 1 time. So the frequency of 0 is 1. 1 is coming 1 time. So frequency of 1 is 1. 2 is coming 2 times. So frequency of 2 is here 2. Next is frequency distribution table. A table which will show the frequency of each observation is called frequency distribution table. So here I have taken the 10 students marks, and then first we will draw a table. First column will be marks, then tally marks, and the number of student. Number of student means how many students got these marks. So this we can call frequency also. So first we will see 0 marks, how many student got? Only one student got 0 marks. Then 1 mark, 1 student. 2 marks, 2 student. 3 marks, 1 student. 4 marks, also 1 student. 5 mark, 2 student. 7, 1 student. And 9, 1 student. After this, we have to represent it as tally mark also. Tally mark means with the help of lines here. So 1 we will represent with 1 standing line. 2 again 1. 2 will represent with 2 line. 1 like this, then 1 again, 2 like this, 1 and 1. This is tally mark. But if you have 3, 4, 5, how to represent? For 1, tally mark is 1. For 2, tally marking is 2 lines, standing 2 lines. For 3, 3 standing line. For 4, 4 standing line. For 5, you have to draw 4 standing line and then 1 cross line. This is for 5. Then 6, first you need to draw 5 and then 1, 6. Like this you can extend it. Now we will do exercise 15.1. First question. In a ready-made garment shop on a particular day, the following sizes of shirt were sold out. So they have given here 34, 38, all this information they have given for a particular day. First thing, we have to arrange this data in ascending order. Ascending order means small to big. So from these sizes, minimum size is 32 and maximum size is here 42. And if you observe carefully, we have sizes in even number 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42, 44. So first you count 32. How many 32s are here? Carefully you have to count and arrange in ascending order. Smallest size, then next, like this, all sizes you have to arrange. Second thing, you have to construct a frequency distribution table. So draw table, first column is size of shirts, second column tally marks, and third column number of shirts means frequency. So first sizes we have here 32, then 34, 36, 38, 40, 42 and 44. These sizes are available. Now first we will see 32, how many times it is there? 1 and 2. See, after arranging in order, it will become easy for us to check how many frequencies there, how much frequencies. So 32 is coming 2 times. So tally mark will be 2 line. Then 34, it is coming 1, 2, 3 times. So tally mark means 3 lines we have to draw. Then 36 is coming here 4 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 38 is coming 5 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, 40 is coming 7 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 7, 6, 7. Next, 42. 40 is coming 7 times. Next, 42 is coming 6 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And last, 44 is coming 3 times. So 1, 2, 3. This is frequency table. After this, you have to answer these questions. First part, which shirt size has the maximum sale? So maximum sale means maximum sold out. You can see here from frequency table, which shirt has sold out maximum? This one, 7. And 7 is for 40 size. So here answer is size 40. Second one, which shirt size has the minimum sale? So minimum from this table you see 32. So minimum sale is here size 32. Third, the number of shirts sold of size 42 and greater than 42. So size 42 is 6 and greater than 42 is 3. So 6 plus 3, 9. So here we can fill 6 plus 3, 9. Next question number 2. In a math test, the following marks were obtained by 40 students. Marks are given here. First thing, we have to construct a frequency distribution table. Second, we have to find out how many students obtain 7 or more than 7 marks and how many students obtain marks below 4. So these marks, if you observe carefully, you can see these marks are 1 to 9 only. You can arrange in ascending or descending order also, or directly you can start, because in this question they didn't ask us to arrange in order, so it's not compulsory. So first here 1 is there. We'll check 1 how many times it is there. Then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now 1, if we check how many times it is there, 1 is 1 here and 1 here. So 2 times it is there. So tally marks of 1 is 2 lines, standing 2 lines. Then if we see for 2, how many times it is there? 1, 2 and 3. So 2 is 3 times. So tally mark will be 3 lines. Similarly, remaining numbers also we can count and fill in the table. Next, now draw tally marks for that. 3 means 3 lines. 7 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 3, 1, 2, 3. Next, second question, find how many students obtained 7 or more than 7. So first we will count how many students obtained 7 marks. So 7 marks obtained 5 student, and more than 7 means 8 and 9. So 5 obtained 7 marks, 4 obtained 8 marks, and 3 obtained 9 marks. 3 marks. So total will be 9 plus 3, 12. Third part, how many students obtained below 4? Below 4 means we have to check 1, 2, 3. So 1 got 2 students, then 3 and 3. So total will be 8 students. So this exercise is completed. Hope you understood these questions. Practice these questions yourself also. Thank you for watching.